Sound the alarms, the air horns, the sirens. Alert the Space Force. Get Mike Pence on the damn phone because we may have had the first space crime committed. Send the Space Force out there. What is it in Grand Theft Auto? Space Marines? I don't know. Instead of having to re-record this video, I'll just put it on this. We'll just put it on the screen right here. Republicans in space. I just remembered it. Okay, I promise you, I literally just remembered it without looking. Okay, from NBC News, a top NASA astronaut is accused of hacking her estranged partner's bank account from space. That's a person on a computer in space going like this, illegally going into people's bank accounts. How? I don't know. Anne McClain, whom the space agency said is, quote, one of NASA's top astronauts, allegedly accessed the bank account of her estranged spouse, Summer Warden. I like the name Summer. Better than fall, but not as good as autumn. While aboard the International Space Station earlier this year, according to NBC affiliate KPRC in Houston, the two women are in the process of a divorce and battling over custody of a six-year-old son, Warden. Warden told them. She said she conceived the boy through an in vitro fertilization and was carried by a surrogate. Now, NASA says it doesn't comment on these things, and probably a good move, because she's sort of supposed to be their star. She's a lesbian female in space, which is obviously pretty rare. No problems with that. That's a good PR strategy for NASA. She can do the job, then let's benefit off of her uniqueness, I guess. I don't know. I don't approve of benefiting off of somebody's just sexuality like that, or their gender, but here we are in 2019. But the alleged victim here says the bank has handed over evidence that says that they have gone into their accounts. Whether that's just literally the bank statements, that's what it could be, but in my experience, banks don't mess around. Her bank, quote, did give evidence to my attorneys that she did access my bank accounts, according to KPRC. Quote, I was shocked and appalled at the audacity by her to think that she could get away with that, and I was very disheartened that I couldn't keep anything private. Now, here's a clip of McClain refuting the claim, actually.
I was shocked and appalled at kind of the audacity of her to think that she could get away with that.
The accusation comes from a bitter divorce and custody battle. Estranged wife Summer Warden saying McClain used a computer on the International Space Station to access her bank account. The pair has been fighting over Warden's six-year-old son. In a statement on Twitter, McClain says there's unequivocally no truth to these claims. We've been going through a painful personal separation that's now unfortunately in the media. Her attorney told the New York Times the astronaut did nothing wrong and was only checking the family's finances like she had in the past. NASA's inspector general is now investigating.
There's no question that a U.S. court, if a case is brought, would be able to exercise criminal jurisdiction over an American citizen. But it does open up the broader questions because there will be cases in the future that are not quite as simple.
I was just checking my finances from space. Nobody will suspect a thing. You gotta assume that's what they thought was gonna happen, that they can't track space computers. I mean, it seems legit. Nobody can track the space computer. Nobody's gonna question something coming from NASA. I was just checking my finances, you guys. The Global Space Law Center director is something I wanted to point out. This guy's job title is really cool. I did not know there was a Global Space Law Center. Nor a director from it. Reminds me of the Ancient Aliens guys. Ancient astronaut theorists believe that there's a Global Space Law Center director. Now I'll leave you with this. This isn't the first time something involving McClain has actually gone wrong for NASA. Previously, they tried an all-female spacewalk, the first of its kind. Obviously, that would be big headlines for them. And right before they went out to do it, they actually realized they didn't have enough spacesuits for the women. Now, whether it's gender-specific spacesuits, I'm not sure, or they just didn't have enough, but they failed their record-setting all-female spacewalk, which was obviously supposed to be pro-women, and ended up making them look more sexist than anything. Not a good look for NASA, even though obviously there's no such thing as space, and the Earth is flat, and this was all filmed in a studio, I don't know, Nevada desert, New Mexico, maybe in the lower ionosphere. Space is fake, you guys. Look into it. Ask the Flat Earthers Society of YouTube. Side note, before I let you go and watch this video, I'm pretty sure the Flat Earth Society on Facebook thing, where they go and say, we have fans all around the world, I'm pretty sure that's fake. I don't even think Flat Earthers are that bad at PR, you guys. Look into it. The globalists.
It's not the first time McClain has been in the public eye. Earlier this year, her history-making all-female spacewalk was canceled when NASA didn't have a second woman spacesuit.